state must stop abusing its power, especially, you know, the blue light brigade.
In court, the despicable behavior of our VIP security services, legitimizing the Zamazamas so that everyone wins. A true story. And what's going on at the FIFA World Cup? Not a single win for any African country. Hello, I'm Jane Dutton. You're watching Eyewitness News. Remember to like and subscribe.
This is Eyewitness News.
Disturbing developments in the corruption trial of former eThekwini Mayor Zandile Gumede. A state witness due to testify today was not able to. The court has learnt that there was a shooting incident at the witness's home over the weekend.
The prosecution team had received a call at approximately 6:30 on Saturday informing us that there has been a shooting at the witness's premises and that there was a bullet that was recovered.
Gumede and 21 others are up on charges of fraud, corruption and racketeering linked to a waste management tender that they were allegedly involved in. Was this a warning shot? The men behind the harrowing N1 freeway assault were also in court today. Paul Mashatile's 8 VIP presidential protection members were caught on video assaulting 2 civilians earlier this month.
The 8 men from the SAPS VIP Presidential Protection Services who were filmed assaulting people on the N1 highway earlier this month have appeared at the Randburg Magistrates Court. Now they are charged with over 12 counts of malicious damage to property, assault and the pointing of a firearm. Now accused number one, Shedrick Kujuwane, took the stand today and told the court that what happened was not assault. The case has been postponed to Wednesday for further bail hearings. Thabiso Koba, Eyewitness News, Randburg.
The DA has called on government to provide financial compensation to the 3 men who were assaulted.
We have seen time and time again how motorists are being shoved off the road, accidents being caused, and now the latest where, you know, young people were actually then harassed and assaulted. And we are here to stand in solidarity with, you know, these young people that, you know, were brutally assaulted and insulted.
Inconsistencies and contradictions in Zandile Khumalo's recollection of the day Senzo Meyiwa was killed were under close scrutiny. Khumalo returned to the witness stand as the trial enters its second week since it has started from scratch. The court has heard 3 statements made by Khumalo between 2014 and 2018 with differing accounts of the shooting. But she denies claims Meyiwa was shot by someone in his group of friends leading to a cover-up.
I put it to you, ma'am, that from the inconsistencies and from your statements and your verbal evidence suggests that the deceased was shot by one of the person inside the house and there was no robbery.
There's another statement that what you are saying has been achieved. I wouldn't come from coming to come and tell the court lies and the police know.
And it's been confirmed that her sister, Kelly Khumalo, does not need to take to the stand. Tackling the Zamazama problem so that everyone wins. Bosveld Mine in northern KZN is transforming the lives of former Zamazamas by employing them as artisanal miners or contractors and hiring the ringleader that wreaked havoc on the mine with an estimated 6 million rand in damages. Mhlonipheni Mavuso now manages the men and makes an honest living.
A group of about 100 community members led by Mhlonipheni raided the mine, invaded it. They burnt 2 excavators, smashed up about 10 cars. 1 or 2 of our staff were attacked with bush knives. And, you know, shots were being fired. Fortunately, nobody else was killed. But that was actually led by Mhlonipheni. He was the ringleader.
This has saved the mine millions in private security.
With this project we are working on, myself and other 30 people sometimes get 0.5 kilo or more than that. That can give us 500,000 rand or more.
And take 2. President Cyril Ramaphosa will be attending another Russia-Africa summit. This comes after he convinced Vladimir Putin not to travel to South Africa next month for the BRICS summit due to the international arrest warrant that's out for him.
The summit background will also offer an opportunity to African heads of state who are part of the African Leaders' Peace Mission to continue talks with President Putin on the confidence-building measures that will create conducive conditions for a path to peace between Russia and Ukraine.
We trust the appropriate and necessary paperwork for the trip has been completed. Riots on the Mozambican side of the Limpopo remains a security concern. South African National Parks is advising motorists travelling through the Kruger National Park to use alternative routes.
We are advising people who are traversing through the Kruger National Park to find alternative routes. We understand that law enforcement officials on that site are working together with the South African Police Services and will give us an update on the situation in due course.
After the first round of group games, there is still no win for Africa's four teams at the FIFA Women's World Cup. With a day five updated from the tournament in Australia and New Zealand, here is TK's take.
African teams are finding wins hard to come by at the FIFA World Cup. For South Africa, they came so close, but yet so far in their tournament opener, they went down 2-1 to Sweden. Nigeria drew 0-0 with Canada in their opening game, while Zambia were thrashed 5-0 by Japan. For Morocco, it was a baptism of fire as they were beaten 6-0 by Germany. But they'll hope that as we enter into the second round of group games, there will be at least some points picked up, if not wins. There were better results for the United States, who are looking to make it three FIFA World Cup titles in a row. Brazil, they got their campaign off to a 4-0 win over Panama. They saw Anya Borges score a hat-trick in that game. The second round of fixtures continue on Tuesday morning, including host New Zealand up against the Philippines. Victory for the Black Ferns will see them secure a knockout spot for the very first time in their history. Thola Gelimganga, Eyewitness News Sport.
And we end there. I'm Jane Dutton. See you again for more same time, same place tomorrow.
Eyewitness News. In touch, in tune, and independent. For the latest, log on to ewn.co.za or ewn.mobi.